汇集天下大事，聚焦华人热点。西雅图中文电台网络电视。
I discovered that even though we're the largest law firm in the state with almost 600 attorneys, we did not do any civil rights work on behalf of people in the state of Washington. If you call our office with a civil rights complaint, the last 50 years we said, you got to call somebody else. That did not seem right to me. We're the largest law firm in the state. We're the people's attorneys. We should do civil rights work on behalf of all Washingtonians. I'm proud to say, in my first term, we created a civil rights unit.The Wing Loop Civil Rights Unit, named after Wing Loop, who was Assistant Attorney General in the AG's office many years ago. We are enforcing civil rights laws all around the state. I ask your support in my re-election.
Ooh, we're all right, Bob.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, you got it, Bob.
Good afternoon. My name is Steve McLaughlin, and I'm running for Commissioner of Public Lands.I've never run for office before, but I served 25 years in the United States Navy, where I had the opportunity to travel across Asia and across and around the world. I very much enjoyed learning about various cultures. In my job, I will ensure that revenues that we generate from natural resource harvests go to funding of our public schools and our universities. It's a very important element of what we need to do for the job.And I also help with healthy forests and ecosystems and fire prevention. I'd like to thank you very much. Chet Chet, domo arigato, salamato, salam.
All right, David.
Hi, I'm Dave Keenan. I'm running for King County Superior Court position number 26. And I'm running to bring a very unique perspective to the court.And when I say that I have a unique perspective, I mean that I finished law school, but I never finished high school. I have a law degree, but I also have a GED. Today, I go to court as a lawyer. More than 30 years ago, I first went to Superior Court as a juvenile defendant. And it's because of that experience that today, I serve as the board president at Northwest Justice Project, the largest civil legal aid provider in the state of Washington. I think it's because of that unique background that I've gotten the support that I have. I'm endorsed by the entire Washington Supreme Court, a lot of the folks here in the room tonight, including Attorney General Ferguson. The Joint Asian Judicial Evaluation Committee gave me their highest rating, exceptional, well qualified. I got a second chance in life. My name is David Keenan, and that's why I'm running. Thank you.
Woo! All right, David.
Good afternoon. My name is Marty McClendon. I'm running for Lieutenant Governor. Nice to meet you all.On my card in the back, it says, what if government worked with you instead of against you, right? What a novel concept. I'm running to change the culture of government so they actually put your voice first, restore community. And I will say that as my wife is Filipino and my kids are mixed race, they understand what it's like growing up in this country, but they only had the opportunity because their dad served in the Coast Guard and sponsored them over. I had the honor of giving his eulogy 2 years ago in church. Over 250 people were there because of one person. So I enjoy the culture and the opportunity that he has showed and the value he showed as well. So I'm Marty McClendon, running for Lieutenant Governor. I look forward to any questions you may have. Thank you.
Hi, folks. I'm Mark Henneman. I'm running for Congress in the 2nd District against Rick Lawson. I do want to say one thing before I really start in. I'm glad to get a lay here. I haven't had one since I left Hawaii in 1982. So it feels really good to have this again. I'm running for Congress, as I mentioned. Got two things that I want to emphasize the differences between myself and my opponent. He wants to raise the gasoline prices 40 cents a gallon.Last time I looked, Stanwood today was $2.74. You guys want to pay $3.14 a gallon for gas? I don't think so. He also claims that he fights for veterans. I'm a veteran. He isn't. I can take it. He says he does and he doesn't. 15 seconds. And I'm not your father's Republican. I'm not your grandfather's Republican. I'm glad to talk with any and all of you afterwards when we're done. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Hi, everyone. Congratulations.
for being in the media, keeping it alive, keeping it going, keeping us free. I was in the media for 35 years, worked for the Seattle Seahawks for 10, went to a Super Bowl, I had a great time. I am now running for Congress in the 8th CD against the former sheriff, Dave Reichert. My name is Tony Ventrella. Did I forget that? I generally don't. TeamVentrella.com for all the information you will ever need. And I must admit that I cut 7 spaces in line. I apologize to the rest of you for other places to go tonight. This is a very important stop for me. And again, thank you for keeping the media alive. Tony Ventrella at TeamVentrella.com. Good night, everybody.
Good evening. I'm Shelley Clova, and I am running for state representative in the 1st Legislative District. So it is a little bit of Kirkland, and the rest of it is in Snohomish County, Briar, Bothell, and a lot of unincorporated Snohomish County. I first got involved in politics when my daughter started kindergarten and I joined the PTA because I saw that our education system was not meeting the needs of all of our children. She's a sophomore in college and I'm still fighting this battle. So I know that it's a very important issue. In addition to that, I will work very hard on education, on affordable housing, on the environment, and medical care. I really bring an experience level. I'm on the Kirkland City Council, and I know what cities need from their state government. And I really look forward to this opportunity to talk to all of you and see how I can connect better with your readership. So thank you very much.
Hi, I'm Rico Tessundori, and I am running for Snohomish County Superior Court. We're up north. My background and experience, I've served as a prosecutor, a criminal defense attorney, a civil defense attorney, a civil plaintiff's attorney. I've been a pro tem judge for 10 years on the Superior Court level. I'm the first candidate in a generation to be endorsed both by the Snohomish County Democratic Party and the Snohomish County Republican Party. I was ranked number one in the Snohomish County Bar Association poll, and I received the highest ranking from my evaluations from the Minority Bar Association. The number one issue facing Snohomish County Superior Court is access to justice. The court system must become more affordable for all. The civil rules of Snohomish County have not been updated in 30 years. We need to make sure that everyone has access, whether it's a family law issue, criminal issue, or civil issue. Thank you so much for inviting me down. Rico Tessundori, Snohomish County Superior Court.
Declared an end to the war on drugs. But most people in this room and most people in America want to continue that war. They want to build more prisons. They want more police. They want miseducation to go around. So I thought I would give anybody who wants to some poppy seeds from Bezos' store. And those are legal. And as soon as you put them in the ground, they're a felony. So that's part of this miscommunication and this education that my opponent, who's under contempt for failing with the education, has not granted the natives. Cecile Hansel's on my board of directors. I'm a nonprofit formed in 91 when I was getting my master's at Seattle University. I had a one-word mission statement, equal access. And I still live by that one-word mission statement. So anybody wants some poppy seeds for
thank you.
Doug Bassler, I'm running for Congress in the 9th District, which is right here in the International District. I want you to know that you matter. You are important to me. I'm actively working to get your vote right now, and I will continue to do that as your congressman. I'm a small business owner. I know what it is to make payroll. I know what it is to make quarterly taxes and to sweat that out and to have to make the rent. And I care about jobs. I care about the economy. I care about you, and you're important to me. And I am intending to aggressively represent you As I've been doorbelling here in Chinatown, I hear the minimum wage too much, too fast. I agree. Now they want to, the government wants to tell you how to do your schedules and those types of things. I will fight for you. I'm on your side. My name is Doug Bassler. It's DougBassler.com, and I love you guys. Thanks.
Everything all right? Thank you very much. I'm Dr. David Shirley. I'm a podiatrist. I was worked in a medical dental building for 17 years. I had a practice here. I retired 35 years military as a major. I'm running in the 32nd district. That's legislative in the north side here, Shoreline, Edmonds, Linwood. Okay. Why did I run? Why am I running? I'm running because I see too much government, and I see government that doesn't run well. I want to take my experience I have, and I want to go to the legislature and make a difference there. My back of my card says, less laws, less regulations, and less money, we have better government. I understand that's fewer laws and fewer regulations, so don't get me on the English. Okay, that's why I'm running. We can do a better job. I see a lot of people that, in the state have been running the state for 19, 20 years. I think it's time to change things. I appreciate your vote. I'm Dr. David Shirley, running the 32nd District. Thank you.
Hello, my name is Pat McCarthy, and I'm running for state auditor. I'm currently the county executive in Pierce County, was the former county auditor in Pierce County, and I believe I am the best candidate running for this position that has the management skills to really take the state auditor's office to the next level. You know that we need new integrity in the state auditor's office since our current state auditor is under indictment. So it's time to make a change in the state auditor's office. I believe I have the right skills and ability to bring to this position. I've been tested, trusted, and I'm transparent. I've been endorsed by a great many fabulous people, not the least of which are my co-chairs, former Governor Chris Gregoire, and King County Council member, or King County Executive, my colleague, Dow Constantine, the Asian Pacific Cultural Center, Lua Pritchard, and the Black Collective, and many, many others who represent our minority community across the region. I would appreciate your support. I look forward to reaching out to you as the election moves on and as state auditor.
Good evening. My name is Erin Jones, and I'm running for the Office of Superintendent of Public Instruction. 45 years ago, I was born, and on my birth certificate today, it says that for the name of my father, Negro man, and the name of my mother, Norwegian woman. I was given up that day to an orphanage and adopted 6 months later by a white couple who chose to raise me overseas. And so I spent my K-12 experience in the Netherlands at the American School of The Hague, where I learned to speak 4 languages. Came back to the United States at 18 years old with the intention to get a degree at the best school and go back to Europe. But I realized as an 18-year-old in the United States that color absolutely mattered. And I realized that there were challenges that our young people of color faced that our white students didn't face. And so I have spent the last 25 years of my life advocating on behalf of our most marginalized students. My name is Erin Jones. Again, I'm running for State Superintendent of Public Instruction, and I would appreciate your support. Thank you so much.
Hi, I'm Eric Newman, and I'm running for King County Superior Court Department 44. There's a bunch of us for various positions. I've been rated exceptionally well qualified by the King County Bar Association, and I think that I got that rating because of both my experience and my commitment to service. I started my service career very early on. I joined the Air Force when I was 17 years old, and I served in the Air Force and the Washington Air National Guard for 13 years. More recently, I have focused my service on the more vulnerable people in our community, including getting to Boys and Girls Club in the Central District, serving at a women's shelter, and volunteering at El Centro Villa Rosa, providing for legal services. My legal experience includes time as a public defender, as well as the last 15 years doing civil litigation. And I've also been a judge pro tem of the King County District Court for the last 3 years, doing both civil and criminal work. Again, my name is Eric Newman, and I'm running for King County Superior Court Department 44.
Quiet down, a little bit.
Good evening. My name is Greg Zempel. I am a
Kidd Tass County Prosecuting Attorney. I have been for 22 years. I'm running for a position on the Washington State Supreme Court. I'm running to make the court less political, more and more predictable. And I think that we need to return justice to being blind. At the present time, it does matter who you are when you go in front of the Supreme Court. If you're an individual, if you are a local government and you're going against the state, you can predict you're going to lose there. Making justice was meant to be blind. I also like to talk about the narrative that has been started in this campaign, and politics can be interesting, but the narrative is it's an Eastern Washington white male running for the court who's going to absolutely destroy the court. So I'd like you to keep an open mind. Go to ZempleForJustice.org, or you might find out that I have a Hispanic foster site. I have an African-American nephew. I am not what some of the supporters would like to say. Thank you.
Good evening. My name is Brooke Valentine, and I'm ready to be a leader in Olympia for the 47th District and to represent the diverse communities of Kent, Covington, and Auburn. I feel like I'm ready to lead from my vast experience. I ran a clothing bank in the Kent School District for the last 5 years. And when I first started there and struggled to understand the communities, I decided to learn more, so I did a workshop on the day in the life of refugees. I also, through the PTA, I saw that kids in Kent were struggling with teachers who didn't have the resources to teach dual language learners. So I proposed an issue with the Kent School District and the board to get teachers better prepared to understand how a dual language mind learns. I was the Washington Legislative Director for the last year, and I've run the bond and levy campaigns for the Kent School District. I'm ready to lead in Olympia and represent the diverse communities in Kent, and I appreciate your support. I wish this was flipped. I have so many questions for you about what concerns are for your readers and your supporters. So thank you again.
Thank you. You might remember me from the Seattle City Council, but my name is Tina Pawlodowski. I'm the Democratic candidate for Secretary of State here in Washington State, and I'm running to make sure that everyone has an equal opportunity to vote in Washington State. On my opponent's watch, voting turnout has declined every year that she's been in office by significant percentages. There are over 1.6 million people in the state of Washington, including women, refugees, immigrants, people of color, young people, people who make less than $50,000 a year, who have not been registered under my opponent's reign as Secretary of State. I want to change that. I'm proud to be a daughter of refugees myself. My parents immigrated from Poland after World War II, and understand some of the issues that, that communities have around that. I'm also very proud to be endorsed by APACE, by One America, by the Black Collective, and so many great leaders like Senator Bob Hasegawa, Frank Aragon, former Governor Gary Locke, and so many more. I look forward to getting your help and support. Tina Pawlodowski for Secretary of State.
Thank you. All right.
Good evening, my name is Chris Rigdon. I'm running for Superintendent of Public Schools for the state of Washington. I am the son of two people with an eighth grade education who grew up on public assistance. Our public education system was the great equalizer for my family, and it has to be for every child in the state of Washington. But today, we are not effectively serving low-income students, students of color, second language learners, new immigrants to our communities. Our system is not designed as it should be to reach every student where they are intended and where they need to be. We have to equitably and fully fund our system, drive the dollars to the communities that need it most. We have to simplify our testing system that's denying kids diplomas, and we absolutely have to bring career and tech ed programs back into our schools.
15.
Our programs to graduate should be as diverse as our children, and today the one-size-fits-all system is not working. My name is Chris Rakedahl. I'm so proud to be supported by Frank, Sharon Tamiko Santos, Senator Hasegawa, and so many folks in the community. Thank you so much, everybody. Thank you.
All right.
Good evening. My name is Cyrus Habib. I'm a member of the Washington State Senate running to be your next Lieutenant Governor. My parents came to this country from Iran. They came in search of economic and educational opportunities. I became blind due to cancer as a child. Taught me the importance of inclusion. That's why in the legislature, I introduced the Washington Voting Rights Act in the state Senate and other legislation to make our state more inclusive. As your Lieutenant Governor, I'm gonna work with every community in this state to advance economic development and international trade initiatives. There's so many ways we could promote tourism, trade, foreign direct investment, and market our state, its goods, and its products, and I need to work with every community in the state to get that done. But more importantly even than that is I want to make sure that every community has a voice in our legislative process. So I'm going to hire a director of outreach to work with all the ethnic media outlets to make sure you all know what we're doing in Olympia and that we hear from you. I'd love to have your support, and please write a profile on this campaign before November 8th. Thank you.
Good evening. My name is Jessen Farrell, and I've stepped forward here. Good evening. My name is Jessen Farrell, and I am running unopposed in the 46th District, which is Northeast Seattle, Lake Forest Park, and Kenmore. And it is delightful to be here tonight. I am the mother of three young children, 8, 6, and 2. I believe deeply that we need working people in our legislature who are facing what it means to balance family, economics, and also taking a role in our government. I believe deeply in economic justice, protecting our communities from environmental disasters such as oil drains and explosions of that sort. And I also believe deeply in making sure that all of my constituents are engaged and informed. And so it is such a wonderful thing to be here tonight. And I look forward to working with you and all the other members of my community in the coming term. Thank you.
All right, yes.
Hi, my name is Jonathan Dawes. I'm running for governor. I haven't seen any of the other gubernatorial candidates in any of these events. I mean, if voting really mattered, do you think it would be legal? Jay Inslee's going to walk into the governor's mansion without even having to work for it. Screw Jay Inslee, screw Bill Bryant. Put me on stage with them for 3 minutes, and I will show you what every other state has that we don't have here. Freedom and a choice and a vote that matters. If you want to find out more about me, you can go to governordodds.org. Dodds is spelled like the Department of Defense.
30.
I'm done. Thank you.
Good evening. My name is Josh Trumbull. I'm running for Attorney General. The reason I'm running is to protect our community from the financial fraud that's been rampant for the last decade. It affects most people when it comes time to deal with our servicer regarding a servicing error or potential foreclosure. You get caught up, and you get put on the railroad to foreclosure, and you lose your home and your life is destroyed. What I hold in my hand right here are consent orders against Wells Fargo. They're signed by Wells Fargo. They're signed by government officials. They're entered in 2011, 2013, and 2015. And what they really are is worthless, because we just saw Senator Elizabeth Warren grilling CEO Wells Fargo for additional fraud. Monday morning at 8 o'clock in Arlington, the plan to fix this issue is right here on two pieces of paper. I'm going to release it to the press. Thank you. Josh Trumbull, I want to protect you from financial fraud, running for Attorney General.
I am Grazna Pravce, for the record, the only one speaking about Agenda 21. Courts, Washington State, impose and control education. Nobody from my opponents taught you about Agenda 21. Go to my statement, research. Alyssa Ellis talks about Common Core and Agenda 21. I am an immigrant. I know how courts treat immigrants' teachers. We have no rights. And please research Prouty versus Tahoma. Connects to McCleary case, that has been no evidence that the schools have not been funded. This is about court's control over all of us, education and teachers, no rights. So please do it for humanity. Do yourself a favor, and we owe it not only to us, but to humanity. Thank you. If you don't understand, it means that maybe active literacy has not been taught to you in the United States. Bye.
Good evening, my name is Kathy Moore. I'm running for King County Superior Court, Department 44. I'm
running because I believe that we need leaders on the bench, leaders who are going to deliver on our nation's promise of justice for all. I've spent 25 years working for the underprivileged and the underrepresented. I started out as a Peace Corps volunteer. I served as a public defender. I've represented abused and neglected children, survivors of domestic violence, immigrants. I chaired the Seattle Human Rights Commission. I served on the Board of Governors and raised $1 million plus for civil legal aid. I have 8 years of judicial experience, 6 as a pro tem in King County Superior Court, 2 as a full-time judge. I've been endorsed by Justice Yu, Chief Justice Barbara Madsen, Justice Gonzalez, Senator Bob Hasegawa, and I've been rated exceptionally well qualified by the Joint Asian Bar Association and well qualified by other local bars. It's a pleasure to be here. I hope to represent your community. Thank you.
All right.
Thank you so much. My name is Barbara Madsen. I'm the Chief Justice of the Washington Supreme Court. I'm running for re-election to the court. I have been the Chief Justice for 7 years. My colleagues have elected me twice to lead the court. Among my proudest accomplishments on the court over these last 24 years has been working with people like C.Z. Smith and others on the court to develop commissions and boards that will actually make our courts more usable for the real people who need our courts. The Minority Injustice Commission was started under the brainchild of Justice C.Z. Smith. I have been the chair of the Gender Injustice Commission since 1998. We have an interpreter commission because we care about people being able to understand court proceedings. We have a commission on children in foster care because foster care children do not do well unless they have interventions. And we have an access to justice board because so many people cannot afford legal assistance in our courts. We need to make our courts usable for everyone. If reelected, will continue the hard work that I have been doing for 24 years. Thank you very much.
All right, Barbara. Yes.
It's really good to know.
Yes.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hi everyone, I'm Pramila Jayapal, State Senator for this beautiful district, the 37th Legislative District, and running for Congress in the 7th Congressional District. I am really excited to be taking my advocacy and experience running what is now the largest immigrant advocacy organization in the state, One America. We have fought with so many of you to make sure that we have medical interpretation, to make sure that we are taking care of our kids in the schools, providing special language programs, all the things that our immigrant and refugee communities need so desperately. And because of our coalitions, we're one of the strongest states for immigrant refugee rights in the country. And I can't wait to take that perspective to the United States Congress as well. I've been endorsed by some great folks that you know, like Senator Bob Hasegawa, Ron Sims, Diane Arasaki, Laura Pritchard. But most importantly, I won the primary with 42% of the vote. I doubled my closest opponent. And if I get to Congress, I will be the first Indian American woman ever elected to the United States Congress. And I will make sure that we continue to fight for immigrant rights for all of us. Thank you very much. Thank you, and I'd love to have your vote.
Hi, I'm Nicole Gaines Phelps, and I'm running for King County Superior Court, position number 14. I'm running because I want to be the change that I want to see in the court. As a woman that was raised by a mother who only had an eighth grade education and a father who had been working in an industry for more than 50 years where he never received a promotion because it was based on his color of his skin and not the content that he was providing, I understand what it is to be discriminated against. I understand that our courts need to be better. I have been endorsed by a number of people, including Senator Hasegawa. I also have 20 years of experience, including 8.5 as an administrative law judge. I have experience as a public defender, a prosecutor, and as well in the private sector. I do ask for your vote. I am endorsed by a number of people, including the King County Democrats and all 17 legislative Democratic districts in the state of Washington. Thank you for your support. Again, Nicole Gaines-Phelps, King County Superior Court, position number 14.
I'm really grateful to be here. I am running for state representative in the 43rd district, which is the district just right over the line here, representing downtown up to Green Lake. I have really spent my life working on issues of social justice, safety, and equity, and particularly around issues of housing, affordability, homelessness, and healthcare access. And I'm excited to be running for office to bring that experience forward. I am the deputy director of the Downtown Emergency Service Center, and I chair the board of the Washington Low Income Housing Alliance. where I've spent time working on housing policy issues around the state and protecting both renters and homeowners from discrimination and displacement. These experiences have earned me endorsements from across the field, including over 30 current and former elected officials, including our current and former mayors, Ed Murray and Mike McGinn, and 7 city council members, and numerous labor, environmental, LGBTQ, and women's groups. Thank you so much. I hope I have your support.
Hi, my name is Dan Shi. I'm running to be state representative in the 43rd district. My parents immigrated here shortly before I was born from Taiwan, and they had a very tough struggle to create a life for themselves here. And that really was something I internalized, and I see now that we're drifting in a direction of less opportunity for so many people, and I think as a state, we need to reverse that. And that's what I'm running for. I'm also running because I want to provide a voice for diverse perspectives in the legislature. We have so few people of color. We have so few LGBT people, I'm openly gay. We really need people who can be a strong voice. I'm used to working in places. My whole life I've been working in business and in law environments where I've been the only person of color. I've been the only person who's openly gay. And I learned how to succeed in those environments, not by fitting in, but by bringing a different perspective and learning how to lead with that perspective. And that is what I intend to do in the legislature if I get there. So thank you, and I look forward to meeting all of you, any of you later. Thanks.
All right, Dan. Woo, Bob.
No bias in the media, please.
So Bob Hoskin, I'm running for state senator in the 11th legislative district. And one of the little known facts is, you know, it's well known that we have a divided legislature, but the little known fact is that I've been the most successful legislator in the Washington State Senate and the House. I passed more legislation last year than any other member of the legislature. And I did it in the divided House. But what I would implore the members of the ethnic media to do is to please be sure and take, while you take the interests of your specific communities at heart, also try and get the bigger picture of what's going on. You know, I have actually steered my media releases away from the Seattle Times. I've just taken them off my list. I put ethnic media because the Seattle Times doesn't care. They want to be paternalistic about how they support communities of color, but they're nothing about building power. And that's what you all do, is to build power for our communities.
So yeah, right, Bob.
Thank you. My name is Lisa Bowman. I'm running for the Senate seat in the 41st Legislative District, Mercer Island, Bellevue, Sammamish, and Sequoia, Lucida, Brenton. I'm going to name only one issue that I'm really caring about right now, there are many, and that's economic development and education for rights. My opponent is head of the Senate Education Committee. Governor Inslee has said, other than his race, this is the most important race in the state. It is the state race to take back the Senate for the Democrats. If we get this seat, we will have a majority in the Senate, and then we can move forward. We can fund McCleary, but even more than that, we can build a great education system across the state of Washington. We should be in the top 10% of all states. We're in the middle of the pack. That's not where we want to be. We want education, superior education, for everyone. And that's what I'm working hard to do. We can take this seat. I need your support. Thank you so much.
All right, Lisa.